So I remember this little joke every time I use salt. And I guess it's not a joke. It's kind of like a story. There were three daughters, three princesses. And the father was going to give his kingdom one of the daughters that loved him the most. And because he loved all his daughters, he didn't know which one he loved the most. So he decided to give them a chance to prove which daughter loved him the most. So the first daughter came to him and she gave him an elaborate gift of jewelry. And he said, oh, this daughter loves me the most. So then the second daughter came and she gave him the finest materials to make robes and beautiful things. And he said, maybe this daughter loves me the most. So finally, the third daughter came to him and she brought a bowl of salt. And he was like, your sister brought me diamonds. Your other sister brought me the finest material. And you bring me a bowl of salt? And she said, yes. And he's, why? And she says, because I love you like salt loves meat. And he was confused. And so he asked her again, what do you mean? And she told him, meat without salt is nothing desirable. So he got angry and he put her out on the street. You imagine a princess walking around on the street with less than the commoners because she was homeless. So one day they were having a ball and they needed cooks and waitresses, what we would call them now, to take care of the guests and the king. So the daughter decided to slip back in under the cover of being a waitress. And when it was time for her to bring her father, the king, his meal, she took the salt off the table. And he began to eat the food that was before him. And when he got to the meat, he looked for the salt and there was no salt. So he tried to eat the meat. And he threw it up. He's like, this is disgusting. Who brought me meat without salt? This is unbearable. This is beneath me. This meat means nothing without the salt. And it was at that point that he realized what his daughter meant. And he started to cry. And they asked him, why are you crying, Your Highness? And he said, because once I had a daughter that's no longer here. And I threw her out because she told me that she loved me the way salt loves meat. And back then, I didn't understand what she meant. And now I know that she loved me more than them all. And now I have no idea where she is. And it was at that point that the daughter raised up and she said, Father, I never left. And it's a beautiful story because a lot of times people say, well, you need to prove your love to me, which is stupid anyway. And you can do something extremely small and they not recognize it, that you're trying to show them love. Someone could go out and buy trips, jet them around the world, take them on elaborate vacations, and they think, oh, this woman loves me. But they don't realize the woman that gets up every morning and heats you up a towel to wash your face with before you get out of bed every morning, or the man who warms up your towel in the dryer before you get out of the shower so you have a warm towel. It's the one that's really showing you the most love, because they're showing you that regardless of my financial status, I'm putting you first. Kimberly Racine.
Kimberly Racine, she step on this and clean. Kimberly Racine, step on this and clean. Kimberly Racine. her say, she step on the sick game. Can't believe her say, she step on the sick game. Hey, I can feel my feet. Oh, yeah, why? Can't believe her say, she step on the sick game. Hey, I can feel my feet.